So the Virginia Aquaculture Conference is held every other year, and it is for industry, so it's an opportunity for industry to learn about upcoming issues and network. We've got a full trade show. We've got vendors that are selling seed, gear, those types of things that are important, but also we've got a lot of resources, so agencies and other groups that have resources available. So it offers a little bit of everything for someone who wants to get in the business or wants to grow their business. So during the conference, we have two concurrent sessions going on. We have the bivalve mollusk and shellfish, and we also have finfish. And in the finfish session, aquaponics is really big now. It's growing, and so we typically spend a lot of time talking about aquaponics. At this year's event, we did a grower-to-grower panel. The subject was good neighbor strategies to avoid user conflicts. So now more than ever, as aquaculture is growing, we have natural conflicts that may arise with just maybe neighbors being uncomfortable about what is aquaculture, what are they looking at, what are they seeing, how is it impacting their navigation, their access to their docks, things of this nature. And this panel was really valuable. We had three members of the industry talking about their strategies, and because it's a two-way street, and industry certainly has a stake in that relationship. So one of the things people I hear often about the conference is that it's a great opportunity to network. So it's an opportunity for industry to network with other growers, so industry talking to industry, opportunity for the research community to speak directly to engage with the industry, and also for agency, for our regulatory agency folks to get in the mix. So it's just a really nice mix of people engaging together, looking for, talking about how we keep growing the industry in a sustainable way.
So what happens when a bloom is occurring